Hi. Oh, Jesus. It's been a while. About a month or two. I don't know. I just know I haven't done one in a while. This is my bed, everybody. The ladies know all about this, though. So I just need to tell. This is like getting the word out there, I guess. But the ladies know what I'm in right now. Because they've been in it. Damn. Anyways, it's pretty chill. I'm just some packing boxes. American flag, because, USA, and if you hate that, then there's a big old middle one for you. A fan to keep me cool in my cold nights. My blanket that my mama made me. God bless her. Sweetest thing on this earth. Sweeter than honey. God bless her. God bless my grandparents and my dad and my brothers and all my friends and family and everybody. And God bless God and Jesus and everybody up in heaven and all that gooey stuff. Graduation. Weird stuff. Going on to our future and taking another big step in our lives. But it's weird because I was, in those groups that we had by the lockers, I was with a few of my friends. I know Gage and Nick were there. And Nick was saying he was scared of the future. And Gage was laughing at him for it. And I was like, he's got some pretty good points. And, way back then, I was just, oh, come on, he's just saying what he wants to say. And now I look back on that, and I was like, it's pretty scary to think about your future. It's a very real and actual thing to be afraid of. Not like boogie monster or sharks or anything, because you shouldn't be afraid of sharks, because sharks are great creatures and beautiful and awesome, and they shouldn't be hunted and killed for their fins. Anyways, what I was saying is our future is scary, so we can't predict it, and no one really can. But that's also a awesome thing and thing to be hopeful about. I'm just saying hope, because hope is the opposite of fear. You should be hopeful and glad you don't know what your future's like. Because you're allowed to make as many choices as you want, and nobody can influence them. Because it's, in the end, it comes right down to your choice. And that's an awesome thing, and I know I said free will sucks in the past. I have a video about it. Go check it out. But I don't know. It's one of those questions that I want to be answered. Like, what does my future hold? Does God exist? And what color? Oh no, I'll say it now. That's inappropriate. Same to the man who's wanting to run for president. Oh, wait, I've also made a video about that. Go check it out. I'm just kidding. It's your choice, free will, all that good stuff. Very, very mad world. High five. Because I don't know if you want a high five. So, I don't know. I don't care. High five. There we go. Here, I'll time it so you can do it with me. 3, 2, 1. High five. There we go. Okay. Scary what the future holds. Let's take a look back at the 4 years, though, that we spent together. Everybody or anybody who watches these videos from Legacy High School class of 2K16. Oh yeah, I got my braces off, so. Zanning Tefron up in here. And for all of those who don't know, Zanning Tefron is the love child of Channing Tatum and Zac Efron. Zanning Tatum. Is there anything with my teeth? No, I'm just kidding. My teeth are flawless. Bite your throat out. Anyways, look back, all the fun times. Now, Dalton, whenever we got to fight, It's okay. I would have won. Oh! Ah, goddamn. No, I'm just kidding. I would have put up a good fight, though. That's the point of that video, which you should go check out. I don't know why I keep doing that. I'm just doing it. Lost my virginity this year. Oh, yeah. Tore up the V card. And I'm being honest. I don't care. I'm running for president maybe one day. Some journalist whose job is to dig up crap on me, then by all means, dig into my past. Lost my V card. Just hope my mama doesn't watch one of these videos. First girlfriend. Sweet, but you know, wasn't right for me, and I'm not dragging a relationship in the mud and grime when I know it won't work. You know, when I know it's not for me, I just gotta get it done. The feeling was mutual, but it's just, you know, sometimes you just gotta look out for numero now. And I'm not meaning any disrespect to her or any other future girl I date. I'm just saying, you know, I'm looking for a soulmate. That's the whole purpose of dating. And if it doesn't work, then it doesn't work. I'm sorry. That's just who I am. Being honest. What else? Got my car. Bless her soul, Christina Smith for Cutlass Supreme. Don't you ever forget it. Don't know what else. It was a nice light. It was like Jesus. No more Jesus? Jesus. Oh, anybody going to Foam Wonderland? June 4th? Hook it up. It's gonna be lit. Oh, and for everyone who wrote my yearbook, I thank you. Greatly appreciate it. Mostly about how I don't take shit from anybody, which is awesome that you guys think that. It's dope. I appreciate it. Gage, Seeley, and Nick Hawkins. You two are the ones who gave me the nickname Big Rich, so I have to thank you for that. Word up. That is your guys's, like, you can brag about that to all your future friends when I become famous. Like, oh yeah, we gave him his name. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, I appreciate it. It's pretty awesome. My grandpa was making a joke that he would be called Bigger Rich because his name is Richard too. I always look back on the junior year, freshman year, sophomore year, and senior year. I don't know why I didn't do it in order, but freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior year, I look back on it and, you know, I look at all the fun times and a few of the parties. The people, the bitches, the assholes. I just look back and I. You know what? Yeah, if I could go back, I'd do it all the same. Because I made great fucking friends and I'm fucking proud to say that. Made great fucking friends. And I hope we all keep in touch. Maybe not all of us, because I know some of us will have busy lives and not be able to keep in touch, but. I want at least some of us to keep in touch. I hope I made a big enough impact on somebody's life so that they stay my friend or in touch with me throughout the rest of my life from high school. Be pretty nice and dope, sweet, you know? And you don't have to. You don't have to feel bad about it if you don't. I'm just saying it'd be nice. What else was I gonna say? There is one thing, though, I would change. But I'm not gonna say it, but it was during freshman year. Take opportunities. And if you think, even in the slightest of chances, that a girl likes you, you just ask her out. You just go for it. I don't care if you You just suck it up, grow a pair, and you ask her out. It's like, hey, you want to go catch a movie or some dinner? Just all casual, like it was like just like, how's your day going? S casual as that. Now I'm not really one to speak because I really don't do that. I get it. I get the butterflies in my stomach. It's scary stuff. Rejection is very scary. But you know what? Changes. Changing. Thinking about asking a girl out Friday. She seems into me. I'm just testing the water so far, you know? You gotta just like test it a little bit. You know, just know, like, even if you have a hint that she likes, you gotta get, know to have that hint, you know? You can't just go up to a random chick and ask her out. I mean, you could, might say yes. But you have to be like Jake Gyllenhaal or Ryan Gosling to do that. Or you could be me, Zanny Teflon. No, I'm just kidding. That'd be weird if Zac Efron and Channing Tatum had a love child. But hey, it's 2016. People can do whatever they want. Anyways, I've said this 1,000 times on Instagram and Facebook and all over people's yearbooks, but thank you. Honestly, okay. Thank you. I'm looking right in the camera, so if you're looking at the screen, I'm looking right at your eyes right now. Thank you. If you were my friend in high school, I want to thank you for everything, for the memories, the laughs, all that good shit. And I might be choking up a little, but I don't care, because for those who are my friends, won't judge me. And I thank you for just everything. And I will miss those days. We will call these the good old days one day. I know it. It might have been shit, and math might have sucked, and tests and stress, but we all had good. We all had good fucking memories at that school. And I can't wait to make new ones with some of the friends I make and some of the friends I keep. It's been Big Rich. Peace out.